Yeah, good afternoon, everybody. Just had Abhay's presentation. So he has mentioned about the manpower and the analytics and the software which is used. But doing those definitely on the ground reality, groundwork has the first priority. As maintaining the practical plants, model cleaning, or any preventive or other maintenance, those are important factor. So that if those are done and if the data is coming properly, then the analytics can be done. So what are the best practices which will minimize the problems and we'll get proper reports and data coming from the side that I would like to cover in it. Some of these slides of monitoring will be repeated, what Abhay has given, but I will skip those. Those are a couple of slides which will be repeated. So basically, Climax is the largest rooftop developer with 85 megawatts on site. We operate, we install, do commissioning, and also maintain the plants. So those are around and sell the power that is in the OPEX model. We have a high skilled professional teams and entire vertical, a lot of them from the different organizations. Been awarded as the MNRE's best reward for the rooftop. We operate in the different segments and a lot of brands are where actually the installations has been done. So the reason why I'm showing this is that on this rooftops, the safety aspect is the most important. We have to adhere with all the safety norms and do proper activities so that the model cleaning and the maintenance work is carried out. So different segments, right from food, IT, automobile, other manufacturing and universities, we have the installations. The best practice first is, as I mentioned, the basically the the work is done by the laborers who are not that focused on the safety factor. Unless and until you always give them a proper training and keep on visual visual display if it is there on the site, then seeing it repeatedly whenever they do the activity, then it gets into their blood and they start implementing the safety. So this is what we have found out, that visual, if displays are maintained on the site, then the safety will be followed properly. The major challenge is the skylight on the roofs of all these industries. We have a natural light, so the transparent sheets which are not able to take the weight of the human bodies. And while doing maintenance or cleaning, accidentally if someone puts steps, he is likely to fall down. So protecting those on the roof is an important factor. So we do a metal cover, metal sheets, not a sheet basically, the chicken mesh, so that any accidentally keeping a foot on the roof will avoid the fall down. Then is the second important, all those are sloping roofs, metal sheet or the RCC. So the person should have a protection if, from skidding on the metal roof. So lifelines are the important aspect in all the installations. So that has to be followed by the other people also. That's basically best practice what I want to mention. So hook it to the lifeline. Then on the metal sheet, when you walk, periodically walking will hamper your metal sheet. So walkways has to be installed so that it will not damage the roofing sheets. When working on a height, maybe a carport or a superstructure, safety ladders which while climbing on should also have handrails and the standing platform, so that cleaning activity will be done seamlessly. When you have don't have access to the industrial roof height of 15 meters, 12 meters, then you use a monkey ladder. So monkey ladders with the standing landing platform is also important so that the person gets down and hooks his safety harness on the lifeline. So that activity needs some landing platforms. With any type of ladder should have handrails. All the installations for the inverters, when we do a maintenance, the person has to stand in the sun, so sunshades has to be there. It is a dual protection for the person who is working on the field and also protection to the inverter. Cable routing, aesthetic wise as well as your safety of the cables, if it is properly laid in the cable trays, it will easy for the maintenance activity. Ferruling and cable laying. Ferruling is for easy identification, so that in future the string numbers should be traceable, which are the strings has any issues. that can be identified. And inverter numbers, again, for the identification, for the monitoring purpose on the portal, we have to see what inverters is, if any errors are there, the monitoring person informs to the field that inverter number 5 has a certain error. So he should be able to trace which inverter is on the field where he needs to address it. Same way with the earthing pits, it should clearly have the nameplate, when was it done, what is the purpose of that earthing pit, what is the new next due date, and the earthing values. Fall arresters, apart from fall arresters, is important to have a lanyard with shock absorber, so that if someone falls, he will not go beyond 1 or 2 meters, or instantly at that particular location he will get locked. And the rest are the other components where you have to use safety equipment so that accidents will be avoided. For cleaning the modules and saving the waters, we use a brush with the nozzle where the water consumption is very less. We are able to use less than 1 liter per module for every cleaning cycle. Those are, again, these brushes have the carbon fiber cloth wound on it. So by accident, if any MC4 or any cable is open, the person will not get the shock. It is shockproof thing. In the ground mounted system, vegetation is the major factor. So need to have proper PPEs while operating the grass cutting machines should be used. These are the slides what Abhay also covered. So we also have our monitoring system. That's the different components connected, and a web-based system we can monitor all the parameters. Some of them are almost 100 parameters we monitor each site. We have a PC-based interface and a smartphone application. We can go up to the string level monitoring. Automated alerts and reports have been generated by the system for the events. Standard operating procedure for tracking the system issues, site issues. We can monitor the inverter performance, inverter tripping, power failure. Then after this, if any errors are there, then the system generates the tickets, and those tickets are being given to the field technician to address it. And then from that, once the ticket is issued, when the system actually it was resolved, so we can track the entire process, how much time it has taken, whether it was in the defined time zone or the more time has been taken by the field person. And finally, these tickets are used for the further analysis, what were the periodic events occurred, what were the flaws in the system. So from that, we can have a corrective actions in advance. Some of the plant photographs, it's a basic GE Pune. This is Carport Nasik, Tata Motors Sanand, the installation. This is Bangalore Airport, Manipal University, Jaipur, NBC Bearing, Jaipur, Asai Glass, Chennai. That's the basic thing. So, thank you.